This is episode 166. So about 4 months have passed since you published your blog article. Do you see any changes? Maybe your page is still not ranking. If that's the case, you need to optimize it. In this episode, I will explain how to optimize a blog post 4 months later. So let's get started. Welcome to the Calm Marketer Podcast. My name is Kenneth Fong, a digital marketer on a mission to help businesses thrive. I'll bring you on my marketing journey where you'll get to learn from my experiences as an INFP navigating an extroverted world and get actionable marketing tips for your business. Thanks for spending some time with me today. Now let's begin. This is the last of our three-part series on how to optimize a blog post after it goes live. So now we need to talk about how we should optimize a blog post about 4 months since it was published. Now, whenever you publish an article, it's never just set it and forget it, right? A lot of people, I know a lot of websites that just publish. They work on the front end, they publish it, and then they leave it and they forget about it. But you don't want to forget about it because you are losing a lot. You're putting a lot on the table, and there's a lot of opportunity to really make your blog perform as well as it can be. So my recommendation is to, like I mentioned in my previous episodes, is to optimize it immediately after you publish it, optimize it 1 month after you publish it, and now 3 months later, so 4 months since publication. So there are about three things that I recommend you should do. So the first thing that you need to do is go back to Google. Go back to Google and scan the top pages, the top 10 pages, the top competitors, all right? So see how it has changed, because 4 months in SEO terms is a long time and things can fluctuate very dramatically. So what you want to do is take a look at how the top 10 competitors have fluctuated since before you published, and compare, see what has changed, see what are the new competitors that are ranking. One thing to really hone in on is to look at the search intent, right? So what is search intent? Search intent is essentially the reason why people are searching in the first place. So are they searching for informational content? Right, like how-to articles or, you know, content that really informs and educates people? Or are they looking for more transactional pages? So like maybe more branded search terms or login pages or buy pages, right? So things that require some type of action or transaction. So on and so forth. So check to see if your blog article's search intent still matches the search intent of the current top 10 pages. And if it changed, then that's when you need to change the search intent of your blog page. In many cases, you might have to just rewrite it because search intent really flows through the entire page, and it isn't just like a quick fix, or it isn't just, you know, changing a few keywords here and there. Intent truly flows through the entire page. So if the search intent changes, then that means you need to rewrite it. But if it doesn't change, then going to step two, the second thing you need to do is to try to see if you can acquire some backlinks, all right? So one thing that you can do, well, let me backtrack and go back to the first one, where we need to scan your top 10 competitors. So you could do that manually, or if you want a more like, yeah, manually by just going on Google, doing a search for your keyword and just looking at the top 10 competitors. But if you want a more automatic way of doing it, you can use Surfer and run a new audit. So in my previous episode, I mentioned to run an audit, but after 3 months later, you need to run a new audit because the data will change. And when you run an audit, at the top, there's a button that says Select Competitors. And when you click on that button, it'll show you the top 10 organic competitors. So this is a great way to truly see the top 10 competitors for that particular keyword. Now, this isn't necessarily focused on your computer per se. So these are the true top 10 competitors, and you will see the titles. And one way to truly look at the search intent is to look at the page titles. Are the page titles transactional or informational? And then you can also see the content score, the authority, and how many words. And you can compare this data with your page as well to see how well you stack. Okay, so now going back to the second thing that you should be doing is looking for some backlinks. So now try to see what kind of backlinks you can acquire. So keep the audit report open and scroll down to Missing Common Backlinks Report. So this report will give you a list of all the common backlinks that your competitors have. So what you need to do is review the list and try to acquire a link from those domains. Now, some domains might take longer to acquire, and it might be impossible in some cases, but you will see a lot of good golden nuggets and good gems in this backlinks report where you can more quickly acquire a backlink. And don't worry if it's like a nofollow or a dofollow backlink. As long as you try to capture similar backlinks as your competitors, that will help you boost your rankings as well in Google. So the third and final thing, now before I explain the third and final thing you need to do to optimize a blog post, I want to take a few seconds and invite you to leave me a review, and let me know whether or not you like this podcast. You know, I've been doing this since October of last year, and I want to, you know, make sure that I'm providing value to you guys and make sure that I'm speaking about things that interest you. So leave me a review. Go to ratethispodcast.com/thecalmmarketer. That's ratethispodcast.com/thecalmmarketer. And let me know what you think of this podcast. So jumping back to number three, what you need to do is redo all the optimization steps you did before. So, you know, when it comes to keyword research, looking at your Google Search Console report, checking to see what additional keywords you are ranking for in the queries report, and making sure those queries are added to the body copy. So try to see if you could rewrite some metadata. So the title tag, meta description, alt image tags, see what other updates you can do. Maybe it's to add additional keywords, to remove keywords, to change up your meta description. Try to see how you can freshen it up and make it so that you stand out in the top 10. Maybe you need to add more content. Maybe after doing the analysis of the top competitors, maybe they have more content than you, or maybe they have content that speaks about a specific topic that you are not speaking about. If that's the case, then you need to write content about that specific topic as well. So just go through and try to re-optimize your page and see what else you could do to make sure it ranks number one, right? So use Surfer. If you don't have Surfer yet, get it. Go to thecalmmarketer.co clickfunnels.com/surfer. That's thecalmmarketer.co/surfer. And this tool will give you everything you need to do in terms of how to optimize the on-page elements of your page so you can rank on the first page more quickly and easily than ever before. So I highly recommend that tool. And hopefully you thought this three-part series was informational and helpful for you guys. Please take action. Let me know what you think, and good luck with your optimization. So with that said, I will speak to you on the next episode.